Do you often wake up feeling like you didn't get a good night's sleep?
Well, it turns out the position you end up in can directly affect how you feel during the day. So which position ensures smooth sailing through the land of Nod? Most of us crawl into bed, not giving our sleeping position much thought. There's the fetal, front, back and side, right or left.
Do you sleep on your side, your back or your front?
I start on my side, but I'm a restless sleeper.
Side.
It's on your stomach, but you have to pull up your leg.
Side.
I like start, like that.
It depends if I'm in bed or not.
The aim is to wake feeling rested and limber.
Jeremy!
So what is the best position to get a good night's sleep?
Dr. Christian Morrow from Bond University in Brisbane is here now. Thank you so much for your time, Christian. Okay, what is the best position when you're sleeping? Front, back or side?
Well, this is all quite individual, and your age, weight, environment, activities, and whether you're pregnant can all play a part in which position is best for you. But the key is to get a restful sleep. You should not be waking up with a stiff neck, tight muscles, or a sore back. Really find a position when you're comfortable. Now, under observation and research, most people who lie on their backs tend to be poorer sleepers or have breathing difficulties. So on average, most people tend to spend time sleeping on their sides. However, we do move during the night. And so sometimes a short part might be on the front, might be on the side, might be on the back. But it seems like most commonly the best position might be on our sides.
Christian, what are the health benefits of sleeping on our side?
So being comfortable is key. Now, sleep deficiency is linked to a range of chronic health issues, heart disease, kidney disease, high blood pressure, diabetes, stroke. And also when we're tired, there's a higher chance of injury during the day. So if you're comfortable and you're waking up refreshed, keep that position rather than trying to change it.
I tend to toss and turn a lot, Christian. Is that a bad thing?
So this is normal. We are meant to move around during the night. And actually, it's quite good because it helps us prevent developing bed sores or pressure ulcers in everyday life. So we want to allow this, actually. Don't tuck ourselves in too tightly. Give yourself room to move on either side, because during sleep, our body will detect and sort of pick up any pain and discomfort and adjust our position accordingly. So we tend to find in the research in general, males under about 35 tend to move around the most with arm, thigh, upper back movements and kicks. But either way, all of us were allowed to toss and turn during the night, and it's actually quite a good thing.
Okay, what about pillows and mattresses? How important are they?
So choosing the right pillow is vital, because a lack of support for the head and neck can really severely impact spine alignment. So if you sleep on your side, for example, you might like a sort of larger pillow, whereas on your back, that same pillow would cause your neck to be quite down. So it depends upon how you sleep. Now, in regards to a mattress, there's no optimal mattress, but there definitely can be bad mattresses. If your mattress is sagging, lost its firmness, has noisy springs, or shows clear signs of wear and tear, then definitely consider changing the mattress.
Right, so we've got the position, the pillow, and the mattress sorted. Is there anything else we should be doing to get a good night's sleep?
One of the worst things is overheating. So when we're a little bit cold, our body can clutch up and generate a bit of heat to warm us up and keep us asleep. Whereas when we overheat, the body has to wake us up to adjust. So keeping the temperature a little bit cooler is helpful, and allowing some airflow through the like nice fresh air just to whisk away that heat can really help.
Christian, just quickly, where do you sit on eye masks?
Eye masks can work if you have a lot of light coming in and that impacts you, particularly if you're in an area where there's opening and closing doors or blinds. Look, if you find you're waking up at night trying to work out what it is, eye masks can be great.
What about the first time that you're in a relationship with someone and then you decide to, and you're going to spend the night with them, and then you whack an eye mask on? Got to be quite careful there, I imagine.
It can, same again. But this is actually one other thing. Sharing the beds with things like animals and children, if they're waking you up, once again, out of the bed. It needs to be a place where you find that you can have that great sleep every night.
Great tips. Thanks so much, Christian.
Thank you.